Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new HibernateTip video. Today you will learn how you can prevent the removal of a parent entity if it has children. But before we start, if this is your first time here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. In one of the previous Hibernate tips, I showed how to remove child entities automatically when you remove their parent. In the comments of that post, Jacob asked how to do the exact opposite. He wants to prevent the removal of entities that are referenced in an association. So today's question is, I am not allowed to delete a book that has a review. Is it possible to do that in Hibernate? Yes, that's possible. If you model the association on the book entity, you can do that easily. You can implement a lifecycle callback on the book entity that gets triggered before the entity gets removed. Within this method, you can access all attributes on the entity object that enables you to check if the mapped association contains any elements. If it isn't empty, you throw an exception to cancel the operation. Another option would be to rely on a database constraint. You then don't need to perform any validation in your Java application. This approach is efficient and easy to implement, but it also distributes the validation over multiple systems. That makes it harder to show a specific error message to the user. Let's assume that you want to perform all possible validations in your Java code. I nevertheless recommend adding the foreign key constraint on the database. You can then be absolutely sure that no reference book entity gets removed. Here you can see a typical mapping of a book entity. The ID attribute maps the primary key. The generated value annotation tells Hibernate to use the sequence book sequence to generate primary key values. Since Hibernate 5.3, you can do that without specifying the sequence generator. Hibernate then uses a database sequence that has the same name as your generator. The version attribute is used by JPA's optimistic locking mechanism to prevent concurrent updates. I explain it in great details in my advanced Hibernate online training. The title attribute maps a simple string to a database column. The reviews attribute models the referencing side of a bidirectional many-to-one association. You need this attribute to implement the check in your lifecycle callback method. The most interesting part of this entity is the check review association before removal method. I annotated it with a pre-remove annotation. This annotation tells your persistence provider to call this method before calling the remove method on the entity manager. Within this method, you can access all attributes of the entity object. You can use that to check if the reviews attribute contains any review object. If it does, you throw an exception to cancel the remove operation. Please keep in mind that Hibernate might need to perform a database query to retrieve the associated review entities if it did not already fetch them. In this example, I throw a standard runtime exception, but you could of course use one of your own business exceptions. Let's use this test case to check that the lifecycle callback works as expected. I first persist a new book entity with a review. When I then try to remove that book entity, Hibernate calls the check review association before removal method before it executes the remove method of the entity manager. The book entity references one review. We therefore expect that the check review association before removal method throws an exception. This will prevent Hibernate from removing the book entity. When you activate the logging of SQL statements, you can see that the callback works as expected. The check review association before removal method throws a runtime exception, which prevents Hibernate from removing the book entity. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!